हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। वेलकम टू स्टडीज विद जॉय। आपका स्वागत है हमारे चैनल पे। आज हम लोग करने वाले हैं इंग्लिश 10th स्टैंडर्ड 1.3 ऑन विंग्स ऑफ करेज। दिस चैप्टर इज़ अ वेरी इंस्पिरेशनल चैप्टर एंड ऑल्सो वेरी इट्स अ नरेटिव आउटलाइन ऑफ द जर्नी ऑफ द मार्शल ऑफ द इंडियन एयरफोर्स अर्जन सिंह एंड डिस्कसेस हिज ब्रिलियंट हेरोइक डिस्प्ले इन द इंडो पाकिस्तान वॉर। And Arjun Singh was a fearless and exceptional pilot who went on to receive many accolades such as the Distinguished Flying Cross, Padma Vibhushan, etc. His stately leadership skills during the war is a source of inspiration to the personnel of armed forces. And this chapter will tell us all about him. Means it is also an inspirational chapter. And I hope that you will like the whole chapter, and also we are going to do the warming up section and English workshop questions. Before going to the chapter, directly starting with the chapter, now let's start with the warming up section first and complete the warming up section, and so that we get warmed up for this chapter. We will enjoy the questions in warming up section because they are very interesting term and we get to know something new also in them. So now let's do first question. The ranks of officers in Indian Army, Navy and Air Force are jumbled up. Discuss with your group and put them in the appropriate boxes. Okay, so ranks, these are ranks. What I mean by rank, the post that are given to the soldiers in our Army, Navy and Air Force. So first one is commander. Commander will come inside Navy. Then is brigadier, it comes inside Army. Wing commander will come inside Air Force. Vice admiral, this will come inside it will be in Navy. Then squadron leader, this will be inside, according to me it should be in Air Force. Major will be in Army. Then colonel, it is also in Army. Field Marshal, it will be in Army. Air Marshal will be in Air Force. Then Admiral of Fleet, it will be in Navy. Lieutenant General, this will be inside Army. Then Flying Officer, it will be in Air Force. Then Commodore, it will be in Navy. Rear Admiral, it will be also again in Navy. Air Commodore, it will be in Air Force. Okay, so this was the answer for the first question. I hope that you got to know about the different ranks of Army, Navy and Air Force, which we should know about our country, which ranks are given to the soldiers in our Army, in our Navy, in our Air Force. So this is a new and interesting fact that I liked. Next question is homophones and homographs. Make sentences to bring out the difference between. So these are homophones and some are homographs, we can say. And we need to make sentences to figure out the difference. So actually, homophones are two words which are pronounced same, but spellings are different and meaning may be different. And homographs is a word which has two different meanings. Understood? So, and it is the same, not the spelling is different. So now these are some homophones, wear and wear. So we need to make a sentence according to their meaning. Okay, now let's make, I will give you some sentences. First one is wear. We wear cotton clothes in summer. Then wear. He sells his wares at the weekly market. Then second one, here ke liye sentence ho sakta. She stood here for a long time. Then this one, here, yani ki sunna. Iske liye ho sakta, speak softly or they will hear out our conversation. Chup chup ke baat kar rahe. Next one is there. There ke liye ho sakta, Sheena was spotted there yesterday. Jagah ke liye hum log indication de rahe. Then there, unka. So they visited their farmhouse. Sell TV ka remote mein hota hai na sell. द कंज्यूमर सेल इज सॉल्विंग द मैटर, ये दूसरा मतलब है सेल का. सेल दे सेल कुकीज इन द शॉप. ओके सो नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन लेट्स टू राइट व्हाट द अंडरलाइन होमोग्राफ्स इन द फॉलोइंग सेंटेंसेस मीन. अब देखा ये सब होमोफोन्स जिनके हमने सेंटेंसेस बनाए. अब ये देखिए ये होमोग्राफ है क्योंकि बियर बियर दोनों की स्पेलिंग सेम है बट दोनों यहाँ पर भी और यहाँ पर भी उसका मीनिंग अलग आ रहा है. देखो फर्स्ट सेंटेंस में अ बियर इज एन ओमनिवोरस एनिमल. सो हियर इट मीन्स हियर बियर का मतलब पता है नेम ऑफ एनिमल. बट सेकेंड सेंटेंस शी कुड नॉट बियर द इनजस्टिस. यहाँ पर बियर का मतलब आता है टॉलरेट, वो बर्दाश्त न कर सकी. सो बियर के एक ही वर्ड स्पेलिंग सेम एंड प्रोनाउंसिएशन भी ऑलमोस्ट सिमिलर बट दे आर डिफरेंट मीनिंग्स. सेकेंड वन शी कुड सॉरी ये है अ बैट इज द ओनली बर्ड विच इज अ मैमल. बैट यहाँ पर नेम ऑफ एन एनिमल एंड हिज बैट ब्रोक एज इट स्ट्रक द बॉल. सो हियर बैट इज अ वुडन इंस्ट्रूमेंट यूज टू हिट द बॉल इन वेरियस गेम्स. ओके दिस आर द टू डिफरेंट मीनिंग्स यू नीड टू राइट हियर. एंड नेक्स्ट वन इज ही हैड टू पे अ फाइन फॉर ब्रेकिंग द ट्रैफिक सिग्नल. सो आंसर फॉर दिस विल बी फाइन के लिए हो सकता अ फी लेविड एज पनिशमेंट फॉर ब्रेकिंग द लॉ एंड यूज अ फाइन क्लॉथ फॉर द बेबीज क्लोथ्स. सो हियर इट विल बी ऑफ गुड क्वालिटी एंड डेलिकेट और सॉफ्ट. नेक्स्ट इज वी एंजॉयड अ लॉट एट द टेम्पल फेयर. Here fair means a kind of public gathering, usually at festivals. And second is she has a fair complexion. Fair means a light colored complexion here. So these are same words but different meanings and these are called homographs. So we learned homophones and homographs in this section of warming up of this chapter. Now let's go towards the chapter. It's a huge chapter. So I've divided it into two parts, okay? So in the first part, now let's do the first part chapter. On Wings of Courage. What a beautiful name to give to a chapter who is a biography, we can say, like that a biography. So this chapter is a narrative which outlines the journey of the Marshal of the Indian Air Force Arjun Singh and discusses his brilliant heroic display in the Indo-Pakistan War. So now let's start. Air Force Marshal Arjun Singh, an icon of India's military history, will always be remembered as a war hero who had successfully led a young IAF during the 1965 Indo-Pakistan War. I would like to say one thing, that most students now think that this biography chapters are very boring because there is no suspense like a story, there is no eagerness because we don't have any eagerness because it's not a story, there is no suspense. That's why these biography chapters are very much boring for students, but you should make it interesting for yourself. How you will say how every teacher says like this only. I am saying you that you should get a message from this. So you know some things in our life, there are many things in our life which inspire us. Yeah, small things in our life also inspire us. Then why don't a chapter can inspire us? Why? So we are underestimating it. If we decide that we want to be inspired, we want to get many different ideas, we want to get good ideas, good suggestions, then we should be engaged in reading. So we should always try that however the chapter we think that it's very boring, it's not actually a boring chapter. This chapter is very inspirational. You will get a very good message from this chapter. If you read different biographies of different leaders, you will get a message. You will get to know what you want to do. What is your duty? Everything you will get to know. If you take it on your positive side, if you don't make it boring yourself, the chapter is not boring. The way of thinking for this chapter is boring. So try change your thinking, I'm saying. Try to change your thinking. Get inspired. or get some at least a message from the chapter, understand it. So now let's go back to the chapter. In the first paragraph, there is an introduction of the Air Force Marshal Arjun Singh, who is an icon of the India's military history. He'll always be remembered as a war hero who had successfully led a young IAF during the 1965 Indo-Pakistan War. IAF means Indian Air Force. So the only officer to attain the highest post of Marshal, the Air Force equivalent to the Army's 5-star Field Marshal. Singh was a fearless and exceptional pilot who had flown more than 60 different types of aircraft. He was a very, we can say, he's an exceptional, means unique and fearless pilot who had flown more than 60 different types of aircraft. This is very big thing, because flying aircraft is not so easy that you think. It's shown in these cartoons and films that it's very easy to fly. Anyone can fly. It's not like that in real life. It's very difficult, and to fly different types of aircraft, and then that also 60. It's very difficult, and he did it. And he was the only officer to attain the highest post of Marshal, the Air Force equivalent to the Army's 5-star Field Marshal. He played a major role in transforming the IAF into one of the most potent means powerful and effective air forces globally, and the fourth biggest in the world. He has a major role in transforming the Indian Air Force to be the one of the most powerful and effective air force globally. And Indian Air Force is the fourth biggest in the world, and he has played a major role in this. So we cannot forget his contribution to the Indian Air Force is monumental, to the least. Monumental means of great importance, enormous. The IAF grew with him. He was the epitome of military leadership in classical sense, and it is therefore not surprising that he was honored with the rank of Air Force Marshal. Formed Vice Chief of IAF, Kapil Kak said. So this sentence, that his contribution to the Indian Air Force is monumental to the least. The IAF grew with him. He was the epitome, that is a perfect example of military leadership in classical sense, and it is therefore not surprising that he was honored with the rank of Air Force Marshal. This was said by the Vice Chief of IAF, that is Indian Air Force, Kapil Kak said this. He was honored on this, and he was honored with the rank of Air Force Marshal is a classical sense, that it is not surprising that a person like him will be honored the rank of Air Force Marshal. It is a very big rank. And he, Arjun Singh, was the epitome. What we can say for epitome? That the perfect example. He has been a perfect example of military leadership. Everyone gives his example for military leadership. This much he has got the respect. Singh was honored with the rank of Marshal on the Republic Day in 2002. Sam Harmozji, Framji, Jamshedji, Manek Shaw and K.M. Karyappa were the two only army generals honored with the rank of Field Marshal. So, leaving Arjun Singh, the rank of Marshal was honored only other two army generals, Jamshedji, Manek Shaw and K.M. Karyappa. He was the first Indian Air Force member who was honored with the rank of Marshal, Air Marshal. Marshal Field. Known as a man of few words, Singh was not a fearless pilot but also had profound knowledge about air power and applied it in a wide spectrum of areas. So, he is known as a man of few words. मतलब ज़्यादा बोलते नहीं थे, करते ज़्यादा थे. Singh was not only a fearless pilot, but he also had profound knowledge, means lot of knowledge about air power and applied in it in a wide spectrum of areas. बहुत जगह पे use किया, wide spectrum, वाइड एरिया, ही इज ऑल्सो नोन एज अ मैन ऑफ फ्यू वर्ड्स. दिस कैन कम एज अ क्वेश्चन ऑफ दिस पैसेज कम्स. ओके सो रिमेंबर इट. सिंह हैड एसिड्यूसली, वट मी मीन बाई एसिड्यूसली, वर्किंग हार्ड एंड शोइंग केयरफुल अटेंशन टू डिटेल्स, लेट द IAF ड्यूरिंग द 1965 वॉर एंड डिनाइड सक्सेस टू द पाकिस्तानी. सो इन 1965 देर वॉज अ वॉर बिटवीन इंडिया एंड पाकिस्तान, एंड इन दिस वॉर सिंह, दैट इज अर्जन सिंह, हैड वर्कड वेरी हार्ड एंड ही हैड स्लोइंगली बट केयरफुली गिवन वेरी मच अटेंशन टू द डिटेल्स ऑफ द एनिमी एंड लेड द इंडियन एयरफोर्स ड्यूरिंग दैट वॉर एंड ही वॉज द रीजन ऑफ द सक्सेस ऑफ इंडिया अगेंस्ट पाकिस्तान. आई एम नॉट सेइंग दैट ही वॉज द ओनली रीजन, बट ही वॉज द वन ऑफ द रीजन्स ऑफ द सक्सेस ऑफ इंडिया ओवर पाकिस्तान. ओके पाकिस्तानी एयरफोर्स तो इट वॉज बेटर इक्विप विद अमेरिकन सपोर्ट. सो इवन एट दैट टाइम पाकिस्तानी एयरफोर्स वॉज वेरी इक्विप्ड विद अमेरिकन सपोर्ट. अमेरिकाज मिलिट्री वेपन्स वर विद हिम, मिलिट्री सपोर्ट वॉज देयर एंड दिस वॉज अ वेरी बिग चैलेंज फॉर इंडिया. देन ऑल्सो द एफर्ट्स ऑफ अर्जन सिंह लेड एंड द वर्क ऑफ द आर्मी of our Indian Air Force led did not denied success to Pakistani Air Force. We won against them then also. So it was his most outstanding contribution was during this war, said Kirk. That's the vice he is Kapil Kirk, who is the Vice Chief of IAF, that's Indian Air Force. Commending his role in the war, Y.B. Chavan, the Defense Minister, then Defense Minister, had written, Air Marshal Arjan Singh is a jewel of a person, quite efficient and firm, unexcitable but a very able leader. So, the Defense Minister of India, after this war, Y.B. Chavan, had written about Arjan Singh, which is very beautiful to hear and inspiring also, that Air Marshal Arjan Singh is a jewel of a person, quite efficient and firm, unexcitable but a very able leader. Really, this is true and this will inspire many people, especially many soldiers. In 1944, the Marshal had led a squadron against the Japanese during the Arakan campaign, flying close air support missions during the crucial Imphal campaign, and later assisted the advance of the Allied forces to Yangon, that is formerly Rangoon. First of all, squadron means an operational unit in an air force consisting of two or more flights of aircraft and the personnel to fly them. Okay, so this was the meaning of squadron. So he also led a squadron against the Japanese during the Arakan campaign as well as the Imphal campaign. Okay, so this was also one of his excellent works. In recognition of his feat, he was awarded the Distinguished Flying Cross, that is DFC, on the spot by the Supreme Allied Commander of Southeast Asia, the first Indian pilot to have received it. So, it is a very big thing that he was the first Indian pilot to receive the award, that Distinguished Flying Cross Award, on the spot by Supreme Allied Commander of Southeast Asia. The whole Southeast Asia Supreme Allied Commander, he awarded him the first the Distinguished Flying Cross Award, and Arjan Singh was the first Indian pilot to have received it. So from this, what do you learn? That if anyone has not done a thing, and if you do that, it's not like that everyone is not doing that, then I will also not do. But if your mind is towards that, and if you love it, then also, but because of others are not doing that, you are not doing it, that's not a good thing. That's not right. You do that and you make a new discovery. You be the first to do it. Then you will be more honored than the people who are going in common side. And this is what I wanted to tell you with an example. I'm just giving you an example of this sentence. And here in this sentence, feat. F-E-A-T. Feat means an achievement that requires great courage, skill and strength. Okay? Then Singh was selected for the Empire Pilot Training Course at Royal Air Force, RAF, Cranwell in 1938 when he was 19 years old. He retired from service in 1969. So in 1969, he retired from the service. And he was first in 1938 when he was only 19 years old. He was selected for the Empire Pilot Training Course at Royal Air Force. It was a very big thing and he was selected for that in 1938 when he was just 19 years old. And at this lower age, he was selected for this. It was a very big thing. So don't ever think about the age. Even now, at whatever age you are, you can achieve something. Anyone can achieve in any age. If now, even in small ages, you should always try to be independent. I'm not saying you that you should be independent in all manners, but you should not try to be always dependent. You should try to become a little bit independent. Singh was born on April 15, 1919 in Lahore, now Faisalabad, Pakistan. So this is Faisalabad, Pakistan. Lalpur was now is called Faisalabad, Pakistan. And completed his education at Montgomery. Now it is called as Sahiwal in Pakistan. His first assignment on being commissioned was to fly Westland Wapiti biplanes in the northwestern frontier province as a member of the number 1 RIAF. Royal Indian Air Force Squadron. So he was the number one RIAF squadron ka member tha wo. And his first assignment on being commissioned was to fly Westland Wapiti biplanes. So biplanes were what? Old type of aircraft having two pairs of wings, one above the other. Understood? So what are biplanes? So in the northwestern frontier province, as a member of the number 1 RIAF squadron, he was assigned as fly Westland biplanes. This was his first assessment when he joined RAF, Royal Air Force. And after a brief stint, that is a short period of work, with the newly formed number 2 RIAF squadron, where the marshal flew against the tribal forces, he later moved back to number 1 squadron as a flying officer to fly the Hawker Hurricane. So and after a short period of work with the newly formed number 2 squadron, where the marshal flew against the tribal forces, he went there and then he again moved back to number 1 as a flying officer to fly the Hawker Hurricane. He was promoted to the rank of squadron leader in 1944. So you can see 1938 he was selected, and in 1944 he was also got the rank of squadron leader. So how speedily he is progressing. And we all people, what do? We are just waiting for a good time. When time will be coming, I will then do progressing. No, you should start preparing from now. This is the message that you get. You should be every time start preparing for your future. I am not saying that you forgot your past and don't live your past. But I am saying that you should be very energetic about your future also. And you should be not lazy that, haan, jab aayega tab dekhenge, jab karna hoga tab karenge. No, if you will prepare from today, then it will be very easy and it will be very fast for you to progress. You will go on progressing. You will leave everyone back. So this is the message I am telling you from this. He was promoted to the rank of squadron leader in 1944. For his role in successfully leading the squadron in combat, he was awarded the Distinguished Flying Cross, DFC, in 1944. On August 15, 1947, he achieved the unique honor of leading a flypast of over 100 IAF aircraft over the Red Fort in Delhi. This is a very big honor that on the day of our independence, exact that year only, August 15, 1947, he achieved the unique honor. So this is a very big thing. It's a very big thing of honor that he get the that honor, unique honor of leading a flypast of over 100 IAF aircraft over the Red Fort in Delhi on the day of our independence. See, such a big thing. After his promotion to the rank of wing commander, he attended the Royal Staff College at the UK. Immediately after Indian independence, he commanded Ambala in the rank of group captain. In 1949, he was promoted to the rank of air commodore and took over as an air officer commanding of an operational command which later came to be known as Western Air Command. So these are all the ranks of Arjun Singh. So after his promotion to the rank of wing commander, he attended the Royal Staff College at UK, United Kingdoms. And immediately after Indian independence, he commanded Ambala in the rank of group captain. Group captain he was. And in 1949, after 3 years of independence, he was promoted to the rank of air commodore. So he was progressing, you can see. So he didn't take much time to progress and took over as air officer commanding AOC of an operational command which later came to be known as Western Air Command. So today we are stopping here only. We will continue this chapter in tomorrow, in next video, and I will finish also, and I will also give you the notes of this chapter. So be ready for that video also. Stay tuned. And if you liked my video, then please subscribe my channel and also press the bell icon button so that you get the first notification when we upload a new video.